Okay, we're gonna do a Mosin top 5 video, because everybody else is doing top 5 videos, and it's just fucking cool people are doing. Yeah, right. Okay, we'll go over some of the top 5 Mosin problems that people come up with all the time. Most of them are horseshit. I've done videos on most of this stuff. We'll do them in one video here. You guys can comment down below. And, so most of these are problems that arise because people are, you know, ignorant, they can't shoot good, or they got one of the millions of Russian refurbished Mosins that are terrible, they were done really, really poorly, like really, really bad, and so most of these problems arise because of that kind of stuff. And it doesn't matter how many videos I do on these subjects, people will still just come up with the same stuff over again, which doesn't really surprise me, doesn't really bother me. Happens to every other subject on the fucking planet, or a lot of them. Written under your net, so it gotta be true, you know. So, anyway. Go over here. Number one is the bolts, normally. Oh, they're gritty and hard to operate, and yada, yada, yada. This is mostly because of the refurbishment program. If you get a true matching Mosin, or a well-fitted one like the fins, that's just a little bit of time matching the bolts to the guns, because everything they had was parts, because they had like in every kind of arsenal going over an incredible amount of the production history of the gun, the production years. If they didn't match the bolts properly, they weren't going to work. So, and the Russian ones on after the war were done very, very badly, and so most of that becomes because of that. That's not the way the gun was built originally, not the way it's supposed to be, which a lot of people say that's the way it is. They'll bring up things like, oh, look, my pre-war Mosin doesn't work good, and this is one supposed to be one of the good ones. It's like, yeah, well, the bolt isn't supposed to match there. The bolt wasn't there originally, because I've seen ones that are actually, the bolts were original to the guns, and they work fine, so your argument is stupid. The next one is the safety is too hard to use, so I don't bother using it, or whatever. I've got videos on showing how a technique that makes it easier. Yeah, some are a little bit difficult because you have a really strong spring and sometimes you got a wartime cocking piece here that's not much to grab onto. But you can put a ring on it if you want, if you're really that much of a puss. Find another cocking piece, weld it on. You can buy ones that clamp on the back, which they look like hell, but here you go. The safety is not that difficult. It's actually a really good safety, in my opinion. It's quieter than 98, and that's another kind of little thing I stick in here. If the 98 Mauser had these same issues that people bring up about the Mosin, they'd explain them away like, oh, well, they're a crappy refurb, or the Yugo refurb, or a Russian capture. That's why they're terrible. Why can't that be the same story as the Mosins? No, the Mosin is just the way they were made. They're horrible. So anyway. Next one is they shoot high. 9130 is probably because you didn't put the bayonet on. Probably because you're an idiot. And the heavier the ammo, in my experience, makes it shoot higher. So if you don't want to use the bayonet, you can do something with the sights. There's different lots of different things you can do with it. But within 50 yards, it normally doesn't make a difference. So if you just got to get closer, more or less, you want to use it for hunting or something. Or you can just use a lighter ammo, won't shoot as high. So if you go with like PPU 150 grain or something, you want to hunt with it, that'll solve that problem. But it shoots high because bayonet's not attached, or it's not a 300 mm battle sight or some horseshit. Rim lock, yeah, it exists. It's, my opinion is sort of, I guess, a case of the refurbishment program as well. You get poorly made interrupters. Yeah, the two-piece one that was never really, I never really thought was the best one. The one-piece seems to work better overall, but they're really old. Some of them are weak or something. I don't know. And it's something to do with the ammunition as well. A lot of the surplus ammo seems like it has a bigger rim on it. So if you go with, like, if you're going to use it for hunting or something, like the PPU ammo seems to have a better rim on it than most. Seems to have less problem. But if you're going to hunt with it, you're probably not charger loading it anyway. You probably can just load them. You can stack the rim so you don't have this issue. So this is sort of a non-issue here. I don't know why people complain about it so much. But yeah, it's interrupter's bent or it's weak or whatever. So it causes rim lock. It shouldn't be a thing, but it is a thing. And the Finns saw it as enough of a problem that they modified their magazines to try to combat it further. But ones that work right, work okay. So, and number five will be they're inaccurate. This has something that just has a lot to do with people can't shoot. The ammo you got is garbage. Like, surplus ammo, most of them, is not that accurate in some cases. Your gun is worn out. The trigger is kind of crappy. Or you didn't put the bandit on your 9130. In my experience, I guess this doesn't go with all of them, because they're kind of an interesting gun that way. There's so many different... Some shoot with the bandit on, some shoot fine without it. Some are accurate without it, yada yada. So, that's why it was kind of fun in the old days collecting them, because you could buy one and it was totally different with the last one you bought, so... But it's, a lot of times, like this one here, and a lot of other ones I get, they'll shoot the groupie twice as big without the bandit as when it's on, which is kind of strange, but I guess it just doesn't make the barrel doesn't whip around as bad. But most are accurate enough. We had like our accuracy challenge thing we had, and the other one, my 1938, I think, it shot like an inch and a half. Most of them will shoot under 2 inches, and that's pretty damn good for any surplus guns. Like, some won't even shoot that well. Some of the other guns that are considered the big, you know, the best milsurps ever, some of them won't shoot that good. There's some that'll shoot a little better. But for, like, hunting or anything you're going to be using it for, probably, it's 2-inch group at 100 yards. That's pretty good, isn't it? Like, that's good enough. You know, iron-sighted guns aren't going to be shooting much farther than that anyway, so. So, yeah, so I think I debunked all those five. There's probably more problems. I probably have a top 10, but that was the five big ones I could think of. Leave your comments down below, guys. What do you think? Think I'm way off base here or anything? If you disagree with me, I'll probably block you anyway, so.